yoga practice for Canyon Community Yoga tonight. We're going to be focusing on our breathing, our breath work, and we're going to focus on our bodies and just tune in with each pose that we practice tonight. Just see how you feel in each posture. I find that there are times when my body tells me I need to back off from doing a more challenging pose, and sometimes my body encourages me to go a little bit further than I think I'm capable of. So the goal for tonight's practice is just to kind of tune in and listen to that voice. The body is very wise, and it will give you clues as to how it feels and what it feels like. And so I think it's really important to tune into those signals, but we don't know what they sound like when we never tune in to actually listen. So it's just a practice to encourage you to kind of tune into that body wisdom a little bit more. So we're sitting in simple cross-legged pose. We're rooted through our sit bones into, I'm sitting up on a block, or if you've got a blanket or a cushion, just root into whatever you're sitting on. If you're right on the mat, feel free to focus on rooting down into the mat with your sit bones. So really feel grounded and centered. And then we're going to lengthen up the spine and out the crown of the head, and begin to lengthen our inhales and our exhales. We'll actually take three rounds of breathing where we're going to breathe in through the nose and then out through the mouth, helping us release any tension from our day. So we'll inhale through the nose and exhale through the mouth. And you can sigh, make as much noise as you feel like you need to release the tension from the day. We'll do that two more times. One more time. If you're feeling particularly anxious, I encourage you to continue exhaling through your mouth. Otherwise, you can close your mouth and inhale and exhale through the nose, the more traditional yoga breathing. As for your hands, maybe you want to put them in your lap. Maybe you'd like to place the palms facing down on the back or on the knees. If you're feeling a little more receptive, maybe you could flip the palms to face the sky. So again, check in with your body and see what your body would like this evening. And then we're going to take a little twist here. So we'll take our left hand and we're going to place it on our right knee. We're going to inhale and sit up nice and tall. And then we're going to exhale and rotate over to the right just a little bit. As you inhale, see if you can sit up even taller. As you exhale, see if you can turn a little bit more. But make sure you're using the muscles from your abdominals, not just yanking yourself over using your hands on the knee. Once you've gone as far as you can, see if you can gaze over that right shoulder and just release any neck tension you might be experiencing. We'll inhale, we'll come back to center, and then we'll fold over our knees, and we're going to kind of rock from side to side, lengthen out the low back. And then we'll come back up to our seated position, and then we're going to rotate over to the left. So we'll take the right hand on the left knee, place the left fingertips back behind us. We'll inhale, sit up nice and tall. Exhale, rotate to the left. Again, inhale, lengthen. Exhale, rotate. Always from the abdominals, never from the hand. Once once you've gone as far as you can, gaze over that left shoulder this time, stretch the neck out in the opposite direction. And then we'll come back to center, we'll fold over the legs once again. Again, rock from side to side. Then we'll bring ourselves back up to seated position. And we're gonna go ahead and remove whatever it is you're sitting on. Come to all fours in our tabletop position. We want our wrists under our shoulders and our knees under our hips. Tops of the feet are flat on the mat. We're going to inhale and lift the forehead up and the tailbone up. And then exhale, pull the belly button back towards you. Inhale to come up. Exhale to pull back. Inhale to come up. Exhale to pull back. Then take two more. I want you to follow your own breath, your own pace. And then we'll all meet back in our tabletop position. And we're going to take some hip circles next. So we'll drop the hips towards the heels and then bring them forward. Switch directions. And we'll walk our hands about a palm's distance in front of us. We'll flip the toes and pull back into our first downward facing dog.
And you can pedal the feet out here.
Then we're going to flip the feet up in between the hands on top of the mat. And we're going to forward fold here, maybe clasp the elbows if you'd like. Feel free to bend the knees if the backs of the thighs are tight. Maybe shake your head no and nod your head no. And then change the clasp of your elbows if you need to use those to help you lengthen. Again, shake your head no, nod your head yes. And we'll inhale and sweep the arms up and around. And exhale the hands. So we're going to go ahead and do some sun salutations next. So we'll inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lift the torso halfway up. Exhale, plant the hands, step the feet back, lower down to tabletop. And then lower the torso all the way down to the mat. All 10 toes are pressing into the mat. Pull the tailbone towards the heels. We're going to inhale the torso up to cobra. Then we're going to exhale. We're going to push ourselves into tabletop position and then come back into our downward facing dog.
between the hands.
We're going to inhale and lift the torso halfway up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, sweep the arms up, bend around. And exhale, the hands to heart center. And I just need to adjust the camera real quick. Salutations. We're going to inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lift the torso halfway up. Exhale, plant the hands, step the feet back, lower to tabletop, and then all the way down to the mat. Pull that tailbone towards the heels. Inhale, lift the torso up to cobra. Exhale, pull the hips up to tabletop, and then back to downward facing dog. Feel free to pedal the feet out here. You want to make sure your weight is even between your hands and your feet. You're not too far forward or too far back. If your shoulders are tight, you can actually widen your hands the width of the mat. You can also actually grab onto the edges of the mat. So a couple options there if you need. Step the feet up to the top of the mat in between the hands. We're going to inhale and lift the torso halfway up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, sweep the arms up, bend around. Exhale, the hands to heart center. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lift the torso halfway up. Exhale, plant the hands, step the feet back, lower down to tabletop, and all the way to the mat. Pull the tailbone towards the heels. Inhale, the torso up to cobra. Exhale, pull back to downward facing dog. Again, feel free to pedal the feet out here. Feel free to bend the knees if your hamstrings are tight. You want the weight that's in your hands to be between your index finger and your thumb. Step the feet up in between the hands. We'll inhale and lift the torso halfway up. Exhale and fold forward. Inhale, sweep the arms up and around. Exhale, the hands to heart center. We got two more here. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lift the torso halfway up. Exhale, plant the hands, step the feet back, lower down to tabletop or chaturanga, all the way to the mat. Press all 10 toes into the mat, pull the tailbone towards the heels. Inhale the torso up to cobra or lift the leg for upward facing dog. Exhale, pull back to downward facing dog. Make sure you're squeezing the upper arms in towards the ears. Protect the shoulders. And we'll step the feet up in between the hands at the top of the mat. We're going to inhale and lift the torso halfway up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, sweep the arms up, bend around. Exhale, the hands to heart center. Got one more here. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale to fold forward. Inhale, lift the torso halfway up. Exhale, plant the hands, step the feet back. Lower down to tabletop or chaturanga all the way down to the mat. Pull the tailbone towards the heels. Inhale the torso up to cobra or lift the legs for upward facing dog. Exhale, pull back to downward facing dog. Again, feel free to pedal the feet out if your calves are still tight. Step the feet up in between the hands. We'll inhale and lift the torso halfway up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, sweep the arms up and around. Exhale, the hands to heart center. We'll take a few moments here, a few breaths in our mountain pose at the top of our mats. Can you feel rooted and connected with the earth through your heels, through the bottoms of your feet, from your feet all the way to the core of the earth? And then we'll take 5 rounds of resilience breath. So we're going to stand in our mountain pose. So you can stand with your feet hip distance apart, or you can stand with the big toes touching. So again, check in with your body. See what it prefers right now. Try to follow it accordingly. So the resilience breath, we're just going to sweep the arms up and around. And then we're going to exhale the hands to heart center. So we're going to do that 5 times. You can exhale out the mouth or through the nose if you'd like. And I like to practice resilience breathing when ever I'm feeling like I've got the monkey mind kind of going. I like standing in mountain pose. I really feel rooted and connected with the earth when I'm in mountain pose, and the resilience breath just helps me kind of check back in with my body. Just this movement, the flow that's taking place with the arms, just really helps me check back in and feel rooted, feel centered, feel grounded, and really helps me pivot from a place that is a lot more centered, and I feel like it's just a better place for me to respond from. So I definitely recommend that. Feel free to try that anytime you need support in that way. So we're gonna take a forward fold, a wide-legged forward fold next, so we'll turn to the right. Step the feet 3 to 4 feet apart. We're going to engage the quads and try to lift them up away from the kneecaps. We want to make sure all 4 corners of the feet are even on the ground. We'll place our hands on our hips. We're going to lift the heart up towards the sky. Then we're going to exhale and fold forward. And plant the hands on the mat if they will reach. If not, you can always leave them on your hips. You can even bring the hands back so the elbows are at a 90-degree angle. See if you can allow the head to dangle and lengthen the neck. Good. turn towards the front of the mat. So we're going to come back into our tabletop position, and we're going to do some stretches for our hip flexors and our psoas. So we'll come back to tabletop position, then we'll come into our downward facing dog. We're going to lift up the left foot a couple feet off the mat. And then exhale, bring it forward, plant it in between the hands. You're going to lower the right knee down on the mat. You can stay right here with the hands on either side of the foot.
You can bring your hands up to your bent knee.
If you feel a little wobbly, try to press that right shin into the mat, and also you can pull the belly button in towards the spine. Maybe lift your arms up alongside your ears. Maybe take a little back bend here. We're going to fold forward, and we're going to shift our hips back for our hamstring stretch. So we're going to bring the toes up towards the sky, hands on either side of the leg. You can bend the knee here if you need to. Your hamstring is tight, the hamstring is the back of the thigh here. Feet off the mat, inhale, and then exhale, plant that foot in between the hands, lower the back knee down on the mat, flatten the top of the left foot onto the mat. Again, you can stay right here, hands on the mat on either side of the foot.
Maybe you can bring your hands up to your bent knee. So again, press that left shin into the mat, pull the belly button in towards the spine if you feel wobbly. Maybe you can bring your arms up alongside your ears. Maybe you can do a little back bend here. Then we'll come forward,
plant the hands. We're going to shift the hips back.
Would like to put the knee back down, feel free to do so. Otherwise, we're going to do crescent pose. So you can leave your hands on this bent left knee. Just make sure your left knee is tracking over that left ankle. Maybe bring your arms up alongside your ears. We're going to do some dynamic movement here following our breath. So really press through the right heel. Really feel rooted through that left heel. We're going to inhale and lower the knee towards the mat. Exhale to straighten. Inhale to lower. Exhale to straighten. One more time. Inhale to lower. Exhale to straighten. And we'll exhale, fold forward.
Step back to our down dog. You can come into child's pose if you need to. We're going to pick up the right foot a couple feet off the mat. Inhale, exhale, plant that foot in between the hands. Again, you can leave your hands down on the mat. You can drop that left knee if you need to, or you can bring the hands to the right knee. So again, we want to make sure our right knee is tracking over the right ankle and we're pressing through that left heel. Maybe you can bring the arms up alongside the ears. So we'll do a little dynamic stretching here again. So we're going to inhale, lower that back knee, exhale to straighten, inhale to lower, exhale to straighten, inhale to lower, exhale to straighten. Take a few breaths here. Exhale, fold forward, step back to downward facing dog, take a few breaths here. Then you can lower the knees and come down to child's pose. And then we'll bring ourselves up to a seated position. With our legs stretched out in front of us for a forward fold. So we'll inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, fold forward any amount. So maybe your hands reach your shins,
and that's fine. Maybe they reach the ankles. Maybe they wrap around the feet.
Also, feel free to bend your knees if your hamstrings are tight. You can actually allow your torso to rest on the tops of your thighs. Inhale, we'll come back up. Exhale, the hands down. We'll take a butterfly pose next, so soles of the feet touch each other. We'll sit up nice and tall. Inhale, exhale, fold forward. You can feel free to give yourself a foot massage if you'd like, or you can stretch the hands out in front of you any amount. See if you can close your eyes here. Breathe into your tight inner thighs and your groin area. Inhale, we'll come back up, and then we'll go ahead and lay down for our Shavasana. So, legs extended out in front,
arms out to the side.
You could put a cushion under your knee if your low back is tight. You could also bring the feet the width of your mat and lean the knees in toward one another
if you have some low back tension going on.
You could also bring your arms up to bull pose or cactus arms. This would help stretch across your chest, across your collarbone. So if you've been working on the computer all day, this might actually feel pretty good. The goal is to make yourself as comfortable as possible so that you can really sink into the pose. So take a few moments here. Allow your body to melt into your mat. Allow yourself to be fully supported by the earth. Try to release any tension or attachment you might have to things that you need to do in your begin to wiggle your fingers and your toes. Lengthen your inhales and your exhales. Roll over to your right side. And then bring yourself up to a comfortable seated position. So a lot of times we have our monkey mind that takes over, and it's hard to slow it down. It's hard to focus our attention where we actually want our attention to go. And I hope that during this practice, you were able to tune back into your breath. It's such a great way to pause and to create space for yourself. In any given day, at any given time, in any given situation. I hope you were able to find some peace and some calm in the midst of the storm that seems to be our daily lives. The compassion, the love, and the light in me honors the compassion, the love, and the light in you. Thank you for practicing with me this evening. Namaste.